Hi friends, my name is Shivam. Welcome back to my channel. So today we are going to discuss another interview question, and this question tests your logical problem solving ability. So the question goes by the name trapping rainwater. So you are given an array of non-negative numbers, and each array represents a bar of width 1, and the number represents the height of the bar. So let's see on the board how the question is. So basically you are given an array. So suppose this is your array and each array represents a bar of width 1. So the width of each bar is 1 and the number represents the height. So basically the height is 3. So let's draw a bar of size 3. Then next size is 6. So the bar will be like this. Now the bar height is 2. 0 means there is no height. 1 means length 1. 4. Again 3. Then 8 and then 5. So this is how my input looks like. Now I need to find how much rainwater I can trap in this. So basically to see how much rainwater I can trap in this. So if I look at the like this structure, if I consider this as a physical structure and see logically how much water can be stored. So basically the water can be stored here. Water can be stored here, water can be stored here, and water can be stored here. So this is the total water I can store in my structure. So I need to return this answer like how much stored, and my answer will be in the form of units. So basically this block is one unit. So I can store one water here, 2 units of water here, 3 units of water here, 3 units of water here, 1 unit of water here, and then similarly I can store, I can count these and then store like 5 units of water here, 5 units of water here. So total I will be storing 10, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. So I will be storing 20 units of water. So I need to return this answer. So this is the answer to my solution. So like, let's see how we can approach this problem. So this is a very tricky question, and you should try attempting it yourself once before watching the video with the answer. So let us try to find a systematic way using which we can find the amount of water we can store. So if we jump directly to find the total units of water, we won't be able to solve the problem. So we need to find a systematic way using which we can find. So let's see, this is the array input array, and this is a bar we need to find the water on. So what we can do is we can traverse the array and find the units of water we can store it above each bar. So if we are able to find that, then we can just sum up the water on each bars, and then result and that would be our result. So to find the amount of water I can store over a bar is, so let's say like this is the bar I am at, and I want to find how much water I can store. So I know I can store the water here. I know I can store the water here. I know I can store the water here. So basically water will be like, so if I say the total water, so water will be like here. So this here, here, and water will be all everywhere like this. So, but I just need to find how much water I can store over this bar is. So basically this is the total water I can store over this bar. So what, how much water I can store here is, I can store 6 units of water. So how I was able to find that I was able to store 6 water, because I need to see like what is the highest bar on the left side and what is the highest bar on the right side. And when I know the height of the highest bar on the left side and height of the bar on the right side, I can easily tell how much water I store. Because like, for example, this is my bar, and the left side, the max height of the maximum left side bar is 6. And for this, the height of the maximum right side bar is 8. So what is the minimum of these two? So because I can't store water till level 8, because it will overflow. So I can only store water till 6. So I need to find the minimum of both of these, which is 6. So I can at most store 6 units of water. But that does not mean I can store complete 6 units, because there would be some length of the bar itself. Here in my case, the bar length was 0. So I was able to store all the 6 units. Had I been here for one, for this node, the height of the left in the left side, height of the highest bar. So if I see height of the highest bar in the left side is still 6, height of the bar on the right side is 8, the highest one, the minimum is 6 and I can store water till 6, but the height of this current bar, I can't store water here, so I need to subtract it from the minimum. So basically what the formula originates it, I can basically I can store the water minimum of the max of left side, the max of right side minus the current height. So for every node, what I am doing is, for every node I am finding what is the maximum height on the left side, what is the maximum height on the right side, taking the minimum of that and then subtracting it from the current height. So that's how I can find the water at each level and then sum up it up. Let's try to solve this using our formula. So now the question is, how are we gonna find the height of the maximum bar on the left side of a particular index and height of the maximum bar at the right side of a particular index? So there are multiple ways of doing it. So let's discuss the first way using an example. So let's suppose we are given an array and we need to find the water we can store here. So basically what we'll do is, for the left max, what we can do is, we can keep a variable left max, and initially left max will be 0 because we have not entered the array. And for the right max, what we can do is, we can find the right max in the real time, like while traversing the array. When we are here, we'll traverse the entire array on the right hand side and find the right max. And then when we come here, we traverse the entire array and find the right max. So this way, for every element, we'll traverse the remaining element to find the right max. And for left max, we just keep updating as we move towards the array. Okay, so initially my left max is 0 and right max, I don't know. So when I'm at this point, my left max is, because there is no element, so my left max is 3. And what is my right max at this point? So I just traverse the entire array. So I'll be there, I'll compare my current element with this element. So this is bigger, so I'll not update. So my right max will be 3. Then I come here, it will not update because 3 is always greater than this. Then I come 5. So 5 is greater, so my right max get updated. Now I come to 5, 7. So 7 gets updated. 1, 3, 2, 0, 6, 4, 3. So at this point, my left max is 3, my right max is 7, and my current height is, basically array of I is 3. So what my formula was, so basically at any level, at any bar, the water which we can store is minimum of L max comma R max minus height. So at this point, my L max is 3, R max is 7, and my height is 3. So basically what is the minimum of 3 and 7? 3 minus 3 is 0. So it's quite clear, like I cannot store any water on this, and our solution, our formula also gives the same thing. Now we move it to second point at the node number 2. Now what is the left max? Because we'll compare the, so basically a general formula for left max will be, what left max is, left max for any ith interval is the maximum of current element and left max of array I minus 1. Because we are comparing all the left hand side nodes. So what is the maximum? Either this element will be maximum, the current element, or the maximum at left max at this point. So this way, this is a general formula for left max, and for similarly for right max, the general formula will be maximum of either array I or R max array of I plus 1. Because from right, because left side we are comparing from left side, and R max we are comparing from right side, so that's why maximum array I plus 1. So that's how the general formula for calculating left max and R max. So at this point of time, my left max will be 3 and my right max, I'll check it will be 7. So what is the minimum of 3 and 7? 3, and the height is 2. So 3 minus 2, 1. I can store 1 level of water here. Now I am at here 0. My left max will be 3. My right max will be 7. The minimum 3 and 7 is 3. Height is 0. So I will be able to store 3 units of water here. So 1 here, 3 here. Now I come to 5. Earlier at this point left max was 5, 3. And at this point, what will be my left max? Using the formula, the maximum of array I. Array I is 5. The maximum of 5 comma left max I minus 1. So here the left I minus 1 is basically here is 3. So maximum of 3 and 5, which is 5. So my left max is 5. My right max will be 7. What is the converting water? The formula is minimum of left and right max. So the minimum of 5 and 7 is 5 and height is also 5, so no water. Similarly here, max will be 7, the right max will be 7 and height is also 7, so water stored will be 0. Now coming to 1, my left max will be 7, my right max here will be 6, so the minimum of 7 and 6 is 6 and the height is 0, height is 1, so water is stored here will be 5, so I will be able to store 5 units of water. Now similarly here 3, left max is 7, right max is 6, the minimum is 6 and height is 3, so water will be stored is 3. Again 2, the left max is 7, right max is 6, the minimum is 6, minus 2, 4. 4, 6, 3. Now coming in 0, so left max is 7, right max is 6. Minimum is 6, height is 0, 6 minus 0 6, so I will be able to store 6 units of water here. 6. Now at this point of time, my left max is 7, my right max is 6, minimum is 6, height is 6, 0. At this point 4, left max is 6, right max is 4, minimum is 4, minus height 4, 0. At this point 3, left max is 7, right max is 3, minimum is 3, height 0. So this is my water. I'll sum of all these water and in the result. So this is how I approach the problem. But the problem in this approach is for every index. So basically for when I am at a particular bar, I'm calculating the right max by going through all the bars on the right side. So the complexity here becomes n square, because for every node I'm traversing to all the nodes to find the right max. So think of a solution wherein you don't need to travel to all the bars remaining to find the right max, so that you save on the time complexity and somehow able to solve the question in linear time. Yeah. So since we already have derived the formula for finding the left max and right max, if we want to save the time complexity, what we can do is we can have for the left max we can have a variable like we have used to have earlier. The lmax variable, which keeps on updating as we traverse the array. So for this left max array we can have a single variable, and for the right max array we can basically store it in array only. Like so earlier we were thinking it of as an array, like storing basically because we were finding the right max for every index of the array. But what we can do is we can take a array itself and traverse the whole array and find the right max. So basically we'll take our right max array in our as our array and of the same size as the input array is, and find it beforehand, like before solving the actual question, we'll just find the right value of right max array using this formula. So we'll traverse it from here and populate the value, and then because when we start solving the question, we'll be updating the left max as we go through the array, and we already know the pre-calculated value of right max, which we can fetch from the array. So at this point of time, I can calculate my left max using the method I told you, and I can fetch the value of right max. So basically what I'll do is, for right max I don't traverse the array again, I just do right max of I, so and I can retrieve the value from here. So using this property, basically using an extra array, we are able to solve the question in linear time, but that adds to the space complexity, which is proportional to the size of array. So as the array size of array increases, our size of right max array will also increase. So this is a trade-off. Like earlier we had n square time complexity but no extra space, just one variable. Now we have linear complexity but space proportional to the size of array. So this is even a better solution wherein you don't need space proportional to the size of array. You can just solve the question using two variables and in linear time. So try to think of that solution, because it is on the similar grounds. You should be able to think it give it a shot, like pause the video for 2-3 minutes and try to think of the solution. So now let's try to solve this question without having extra space of which is proportional to the size of array. So earlier what we were doing is we were traversing the array in one direction. So in that case we must have the value of rmax for every index. So that's why we needed an extra array which showed the right max for each index. Now what we can do is we can traverse the array in both directions. Basically we'll have a low variable which is at the start of the array, and we'll have a high variable which is at the end of the array, at the n-1 index. And what we do is we basically calculate the order at the index which has the smaller value first. So we'll compare the value at low index, we'll compare the value of high index, and whichever is smaller, we'll first find water at that index. So now, since we are calculating the water at the smaller at the index which has a smaller value, so now we don't need to compare the low lmax and rmax. We just have to find the in case of low we just need to have the lmax. In the case of high, we just need to have the high rmax. So that's how we reduce our problem, and we don't need lmax and rmax for both of the indexes. So what we'll do here is we'll basically have two variables. One is lmax, another is rmax. And as I told you, a variable low to which is at the initial zero position, and high which is at the n-1 position. So I'll write the code for this this question. So initially I'll have a lmax which will be zero, I'll have a rmax which will be zero, and I'll have a low which will be zero, and I'll have a high which will be the size which will be the last index, that is n-1. And then we'll run a loop. Basically we'll have a while loop wherein we check while low is less than equals to high. So basically we are having this while loop to make sure we are processing all the elements in the array. Then what I told you we need to do is we need to compare the array of low and array of high. So I need to check which is bigger. So if array of low is smaller than array of high, this means this element is smaller. So what I do is I need to compare this. Since my array low is smaller, so I need to compare it with the lmax. At this point I don't need to compare it with right max, because I know that this element is smaller than this element. So I'll compare it with lmax, and if my array of low is greater than lmax, which means it is greater than all the elements on the left hand side, so that means no water can be stored on it. But if it is smaller than lmax, then we'll find the water, which will be lmax minus current height. So I'll check if my array of low is greater than lmax, which is the case because lmax initially is 0 and array of low is 3. So it is greater than this, so I'll update the lmax to the array of low, and no water is stored. But if array of low is not smaller, is not greater than it, lmax, but it is smaller, then what I'll do is I'll update the my result. So I also have a variable result wherein I'm storing the entire water I can store. So initially it is 0, now it will be result is equals to result plus what will be my result, lmax minus array of low. So I in the else part I've added the my water which can be stored on that bar. And then what I do is I'll increment the low variable, because I have processed the water on this node, now I move to this node. So my low is here, high is here. So my if part ends because I have solved the case wherein my low is smaller. Now the else part wherein my array high is smaller. So in that case, since earlier I was comparing the array of low with lmax, now I compare with array of high with rmax. So this is the same condition. So in this condition, if my array high is greater than rmax, which means it is greater than all the elements on the right hand side, so no water can be stored, so I need to update the rmax. So I'll update the rmax is equals to array of high in the else part, which means my array of high is smaller than, which means there exists a rmax which exists a bar which is at higher height. So I'll update the water. So basically I'll update the result, which will be rmax minus array of high result plus equals to. So I've added the value to result, and then I update the high. So basically I've read the high minus minus. I decrement the high because I have processed this, so I make it one less. So this is how, and in the end I can return the result. So this is how I can find the water which I can store in the question using just few variables, and I don't care like how long the area can increase, my these variables will not increase. So my like extra space I'm using is not proportional to the size of array. So I hope it is clear to you now, like the solution which we, like how we were able to just solve it using these variables and not the array which stored the RMX. So if you have any question or any doubt, you can feel free to comment in the comments. I'll be more than happy to reply there. Thank you.